1993. I was a mere 14 years old and I was obsessed with video games, much like I still am today. Manchester United were the inaugural Premier League champions, Jurassic Park was in the cinemas, Nirvana and the whole grunge revolution were still dominating MTV, and video games were getting used to a newfangled technology known as CD Rom. Early CD-ROM games often featured voice acting and were basically PC games with extra soundtracks, but titles were beginning to appear that would change that, such as Myst, and the focus of today's review, The Seventh Guest. Now, The Seventh Guest originally did launch in 1993 for MS-DOS and was developed by Trilobyte Games as a way of showing off what could be done with CD-ROM technology. The game took over 2 years to develop before being released and was released by the Virgin label. Ultimately, The Seventh Guest sold over 2 million copies and was considered to be quite a substantial hit at the time. Although, as with many games of the period, time has not been too kind to its looks. The low resolution 640 by 320 graphics at 256 colours, whilst at the time cutting edge, now looks somewhat quaint and antiquated, with a blocky cult texture to them and colour that isn't quite right. However, The Seventh Guest has lingered long in people's memories, being released for a number of other formats such as the CDI, a Windows port, a Mac OS port, and eventually ports to mobile devices such as iOS. There have been attempts to resurrect the game in the past, but now, thanks to the wonders of Kickstarter and a little bit of good luck, a 25th anniversary remaster from the newly relaunched Trilobyte Studios has arrived on GOG and all the other major services. So let's have a look at this game today. And here we have The Seventh Guest 25th anniversary edition. As you can see, the graphics hold up quite nicely, all things considered. You know, going from 640 480 renders to a modern 1080p resolution, they look pretty good. You can see the new hotspots in action there. They help you when it comes to figuring out which parts of the screen are clickable, which parts aren't. You know, it is a small change to how the game plays. You know, different icons will show you different things. You know, I've clicked on the clock here and it starts a little FMV sequence up, which shows you a little animation. Now, whilst these do look quite crude by modern standards, at the time they were state of the art. Get a video sequence up now so I can show you what the live action FMV looks like. Here we go. My dear Mrs. As you can see, the original source material is shown up for the problems that it does have here. It's low colour depth, it's quite blocky, it's a bit grainy and blurry, but it has a certain feel to it which works for the game. These are supposed to be ghosts that you're seeing, so that rough freakiness of it does help make them look like ghosts. Now, gameplay-wise, The Seventh Guest is basically a point-and-click adventure which relies upon you solving logic puzzles similar to sliding blocks, placing items in specific orders, which sounds relatively simple, and some of the puzzles in the game are. However, some of them are bloody awkward. Having played the original version of The Seventh Guest, it does appear to me so far that all the puzzles are basically the same. I am enjoying this game. I enjoyed it originally, even though the gameplay is somewhat limited, but even now the logic puzzles are entertaining and the Stealth Mansion is interesting to explore. You know, it's a nicely rendered space. There is logic to the layout of the rooms, which often wasn't the case in many adventure games at the time. If you tried to map them, you just couldn't quite get the logic of the spaces, whereas as this is set within a physical house, the layout, the room locations, it all makes sense. Now, I would say, if you don't like point-and-click adventures, if you don't like logic puzzles, you're not going to enjoy this game. If you do, if you played this originally, it's great fun to revisit it and have a laugh. It's still a fun game to play, and here's where I managed to crash it. But yeah, overall, I'd say this game is worth a 4 out of 5 if you're somebody who played this game originally. If not, you may struggle with it. It might only be a 2.5 to 3 out of 5. So there you go. That was the 7th Guest 25th Anniversary Edition. If you think it might be for you, you can get it now on GOG.com. It's a reasonable price. And yeah, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget, hit the like and subscribe buttons. Hit the bell if you want to be notified of any new uploads. Check out my old videos. And just, yeah, let people know about the channel. Share the video. Leave comments below if you didn't like it as well. Tell me why you didn't like it. Tell me what's wrong so I can learn. This is Learned Rob saying thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.